Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? With Autumn Constellations Ascendant, let's look at one of the prominent ones. But first, some astronomy theater. The Princess Andromeda was the daughter of Cepheus and Cassiopeia. Unfortunately for Andromeda, her mom boasted about her beauty, and the only way to stave off the sea monster sent by Poseidon was for Cepheus to sacrifice his daughter on the shore. But Perseus the hero was passing through and killed the sea creature before it could harm Andromeda. The hero and the princess were then married. Rising in the east after sunset are the three brightest stars of Andromeda: Alpheratz, Myrac, and Almac. These second-magnitude suns may all appear similar in brightness to us, but there's quite a bit of difference among the three. Alpheratz is a B-class, blue-white star that's almost 100 light-years away. Now, this star is hot at about 13,800 Kelvin, but what's more interesting is the specifics of the spectral class at B9. That means it's a Mercury-manganese star, containing not only high concentrations of those elements, but also xenon and gallium. And Alpheratz is the brightest star of this type that's known. Myrac, by contrast, is much different. An M-class red star, it is less than one-third as hot as Alpheratz, radiating at just 3,700 Kelvin. But while Alpheratz was about three times the size of the sun, Myrac has bloated up to 100 times the sun's size, which is why it looks nearly as bright as Alpheratz, despite being located twice as far away at 197 light-years. Look for the yellowish-orange color through a small telescope. And at the foot of Andromeda is Almac. This is like the autumn Albireo, as this double star sports a yellow and blue pair, though they are closer together than the actual Albireo over in Cygnus. Almac is quite an interesting system, as the dimmer blue companion isn't just a single star, it's actually part of a three-star system. Though we can't see the two dimmer components, the blue and yellow pair is a superb sight in any small telescope. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. This week, give a hand to Globe at Night. If you can locate the Great Square of Pegasus, you can submit what your sky looks like to help measure and track light pollution. It only takes a few minutes. Visit globeatnight.org, click on the Observe tab, then scroll down to the current month's constellation. For October, it's Pegasus. Easy to find and see, and easy to measure and submit observations. Do it this week. Backing up to Myrac, we can find the next closest spiral galaxy to our own Milky Way. Look from Myrac up towards Cepheus, about a right angle from Almac. Just a short 4 degrees away is Mu Andromedae. Now, Mu is an A-class star, so it really does look very white in color. Travel on a line from Myrac, through Mu, and hop a similar distance past Mu, about 4 more degrees. Even in many small finder scopes, the glow from the heart of the Andromeda galaxy is visible. While this immense spiral of billions of stars spans about 3 degrees of sky, in most telescopes from light-polluted areas, only the bright central core is visible. This galaxy is 2.2 million light-years away. Now think about that for a moment. Light from the stars of this galaxy left there on its way towards the Milky Way around the time the first members of the Homo genus were evolving as life forms here on Earth. And the light from that galaxy is finally reaching your Homo sapiens eye tonight. Pretty amazing, eh? Something fun to think about as you observe this next closest spiral over the course of this week. Mars is the lone naked eye planet left in the evening sky, though at 6 arcseconds of diameter, it won't be much to look at without a larger telescope at 300 times magnification or higher. Over in the morning sky, the king of the planets sits just west of Leo the lion, and the moon joins Jove on the morning of October 17th and October 18th. Do you like these kinds of videos? Subscribe, follow, like Eyes on the Sky on social media, but importantly, consider sharing this video with others so we can educate about interesting things in the night sky and make others aware of light pollution issues. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.